on this East Coast built Pearson Triton with a fractional rig, we're converting it to a masthead rig. So we've got a new spar here laying alongside the old one, and this is where the shrouds terminated on the old fractional rig. You can see the old mast has been damaged and it's got a lot of corrosion. Plus the fractional rig is kind of awkward, so I prefer the masthead rig. And the new mast is just over a foot shorter than the old one. And the lost mainsail area will be made up in a larger jib area. Here, three quarters of the way up the mast, is the staysail stay and the intermediate aft shrouds. And that's the pole topping lift. Halyard exits. We're ready to hoist the mast. We're first attaching these shrouds temporarily from the new rigging to some old rigging at the lower ends with these U-bolts, and then later, once we get the mast perfectly aligned, then we'll put the stay locks on and new turnbuckles. We hold up the new turnbuckle with the fittings on, the turnbuckle two-thirds open, line it up on the clevis pin, and take the new wire down here to the base of the upper staylock fitting body and mark it there, and then cut it. To cut this rigging wire, I like to use a 4.5-inch angle grinder because it's fast, and we just use a 1/16-inch thick metal cutting disc. Anything thicker than that will build up too much heat. And also, to avoid heat damaging the wire when cutting, I just cut a little bit, then back off and cut a little more while spraying water on it. And otherwise, you can use a heavy-duty cable cutter if you have one, or you can make up a wooden block and drill a hole through it and stick the wire through and then cut through with a hacksaw. And then you can reuse that block for future wires. Okay, next we take the staylock fitting out. This is a staylock stud for 7/32 wire. There's the cone inside, and there's a former down in there you don't want to lose. This piece slides onto the wire after it's cut to the correct length. Slide it up out of your way, and then put some tape around it so it doesn't fall off. Then we want to unwind the outer strands from the inner strands. Then we want to put this cone on the center. If there's some burrs here, we need to file them off. Slide that up. And for this diameter wire, we want to slide that up so that there's about 3/16 of an inch of the wires
sticking out from the end there. And then we want to wrap this back up like that by twisting it. And when you get it most of the way wrapped, then take this top piece back down to hold it while you pull them around to get them to line up in a nice even wrap. And there's a hole there, a slot, but you don't want the wire to get stuck like that down in the slot. You want to keep pushing them further along until they won't go any further. And then space them out kind of evenly. And you want to apply a little more pressure here going this way to hold what you've got as you space them out. Put just a drop of multi-caulk on the threads so that we don't gall the threads when we assemble it. That'll lubricate them. And then we turn the bottom part of the Sta-lok on and we'll tighten that with the wrenches as a dry fit, just to check that we've got it assembled correctly and all the wires are bending properly without any jams or unraveling. Okay, and after tightening, you take it back apart here and you check that it's bent in without any wires falling into the slot, and that this has stayed nice even wrap and not separated. And then you can put about half of that hole filled up with multi-caulk. Like that. And then final assemble. And then it squeezes out the top. You know that it's filled all of the cone area and it won't have a buildup of salt in there. Put that together tight. Now we'll thread the body of the turnbuckle back on so that it is equally threaded in to the bottom side. About like that. I prefer the masthead rig over the original fractional rig because it's less complicated and more stable. And the way we've set this one up is it has added forward lower shrouds, which were not on the original fractional rig. And it's got the upper shroud there in the center that goes all the way up the mast, and then the lower shroud. And aft of that is the intermediate backstay to support the inner forestay, which we have for a hoisting a storm jib. And there's a plastic sleeve over that to protect the mainsail from chafe. And they go up to a point 3/4 of the way up the mast, exactly opposite of the inner stay, to support that when it's got the storm jib on it. And it also gives some redundancy to the rig So in its stored position back here, the inner stay has got a snap shackle, and that can be taken off and attached either here on the deck just forward of the hatch, which will give you good clearance for tacking the jib but still support the mast. And then if you want to put a storm jib on it, you can put it on this forward position on this pennant here. These intermediate aft shrouds can stay in this position for supporting the storm jib, or if you want extra support, you can move the windward one by releasing the snap shackle, loosen the turnbuckle, and put a pennant on it and attach it to a track cleat or stanchion base. The installation of the roller furler and the retractable Code Zero sprit pole will show in a future video. And the new boom is set up for reefing here at the mast. And there's a reef hook, cleat for the reef lines, winch, and that's where the three reef lines will come out. Instead of cotter pins that are troublesome to remove, we've got these Velcro wrap pins, they're called. And those make for quick and easy adjustment. These external chain plates are less prone to leaking and easier to rebed and inspect than the inboard ones I have here on my boat. And they are also 3 inches further outboard, so the downside is that that increases the sheeting angle when close hauled, which gives a couple degrees less windward ability. The rigging wire should be tensioned to about 10% of the breaking strength of the wire. And in this case, I could use a loose tension gauge, but I can also tension it by feel and then final adjustment under sail. But first we start off by getting the top of the mast centered fore and aft by hanging a weight on the main halyard and letting it hang down to see how far the mast is raking forward or aft. And then we check it side to side by taking the main halyard down to the chain plate clevis pin on each side. And once the mast is centered at the top, then we can start tensioning it from top down. And then under sail, when the boat is beating on one tack, we'll adjust the slack out of the leeward side and then tack it and put the same amount of turns on the windward turnbuckles, which are now going to be the leeward side.